We present Tony Hancock, Sidney James, Bill Kerr, Hattie Jakes, and Kenneth Williams in
Hancock's Alpha.
We present Tony Hancock, Sidney James, Bill Kerr, Hattie Jakes, and Kenneth Williams in
Hancock's Alpha.
Pass the box of tissues, please, Sid. There's a good man.
Get your own box, Hancock. I don't want any more of your germs.
Oh, come on, Sid. What's mine is yours and all that.
Oh, we're not flaming married, you know. You didn't have to share your flaming coal with me, did you?
This is not a cold, Sid. It's been conclusively proved by some of the finest scientific minds that there is no such thing as man flu. I have flu.
Yeah, well, in that case, so have I. Which one have we got?
A good point, Sid. Well, at the last count, there are three different varieties. The black, the purple with white spots, and red with pink spots. In other words, Australian, French, and Japanese. I think I've got all three.
You're making all that up, aren't you? Flu's just flu, isn't it?
Normally, yes, but this time around, we are actually staring death in the face, Sid, old chap. What we have is a combined assault by a virus, part Australian, part French, and part Japanese.
Blimey, sounds like the flu virus is having a bit of a party, and we've been invited.
No, don't be fooled, Sid. It's a deliberate act of sabotage. While our cricketers were going over to Australia, they sent Australians over here to give us the flu. Somewhere on a flight over the Pacific, they met a Japanese rock band and a photo shoot of models for Vogue magazine, and that was that.
So who are the Australians, then?
Flannelled fools, of course, Sid. They've got our lot, and we've got some of theirs. It balances things up. Unfortunately, their lot had flu, and it's interbred.
Well, what did we send over there, then?
Two short legs, a silly point, and a backward deep mid-wicket. Rarely known to be fatal, that lot. However, Australian, French, and Japanese flu is a killer.
What are we going to do about it, then, Hancock? It's not my time to go.
Here, borrow my pad and a pen, Sid. I'm making my last will and testament. I'm leaving everything to my sisters Doris and Desiree.
You've got a sister called Desiree? I thought Desiree was a variety of potato.
You're quite right, I meant Deirdre. She's a lovely girl, takes after me, extremely witty, looks a bit like a potato. Yes, they are getting everything.
What about me? Don't I get something? What happens when you've gone?
There's no point, is there, Sid? What time is it? By the time the clock strikes three, we'll both be in a queue of ambulances outside accident and emergency.
Well, I'd have left you my share of the betting office.
What good will that be to me? So I'd be able to take bets on whether Sid James will hurdle the pearly gates before St. Peter can collar him. What is your share of the betting office anyway? The hat with the shade on, the chair, the waste bin, or the part of sporting life? No, thank you very much.
Now I'm going down the doctor's. There must be something we can do.
There's no point. We won't get 30 feet from the front door. I've heard they're operating a curfew, and we'll be shot before you get to the doctor's.
Did you get all that information from, for heaven's sakes?
It's here in black and white. It's the Daily Star. Very informative. Apparently Australian, French and Japanese flu started yesterday on a flight from Sydney, and by midday half the population of Luton was dead.
You can't believe the Daily Star, Hancock. They make half of it up, and the other half is photoshopped.
No, I rely on the Daily Star, Sid. They're the only ones prepared to tell us the truth. You won't read this sort of stuff in The Guardian or The Telegraph, will you?
Exactly, because it's only flu, and that's what we got. We'll be right as rain in a couple of days.
Yes, and what odds are Sid James Turf Accountants offering on that, then? Well, if you think so, I might as well call the undertakers right now. Ingrowing toenail, he said. Ingrowing toenail, my Aunt Nelly. It was a nail from a horse that had gone right through my foot. Four operations I had to have.
Come on, get a grip. How bad do you feel? You're not turning black, you know.
Well, that's where you're wrong. I looked in the mirror and half me face was.
That's because you haven't shaved. It's stubble.
I suppose you could be right. Perhaps I'm overreacting. It could be just Japanese flu, I suppose. I just don't want the triple whammy, Sid. At the end, you start talking in tongues and singing the Marseillaise in an Australian accent. And then you start hugging trees and asking for eucalyptus.
Might just be French flu. It could be good old swine flu. Remember that?
How could I forget swine flu, Sid? It put me off bacon sandwiches for life. Anyway, Hattie called earlier. She said she was going to come over with Kenneth. There's something she wants to tell us.
Has she had the flu, Hancock?
I don't know. She said she flew to Australia once. I don't think she was getting the gist of it.
Oh, you poor dears. How are you feeling? Can I make you a hot drink with some honey and lemon?
Hello, Hat. Yes, that would be very nice. You could put a tot of brandy in mine if you like.
It's okay, Tony. Man flu isn't very nice.
It's not man flu, Hattie. That's sexist, that is. It implies that men are liars who are too stupid to know when they are ill.
Oh, that's correct. I couldn't have put it better myself. I've never had man flu, you know.
No, why doesn't that surprise me?
Oh, there you go, looking for an innuendo when there is none. It's because I never get ill, that's why. Nothing to do with my amazing manhood, you know.
So you've never been ill, Kenneth. You must be a really tough guy.
Ah, don't encourage him, Matty. You'll be telling stories and stuff.
Well, there was a time once I was at school, and they took a look at me and said, "Oh no, Kenneth, you must go back to bed. You're looking a bit queer." I soldiered on, though. It was the final of the school eights, and I helped a combined crew of Oxford and Cambridge 3-0. I got a really try, you know.
Well, that's hard to believe, Kenneth. It's so amazing.
What did I tell you, Matt? You'll have circumnavigated the world with one leg hanging off in a minute.
I'm going to be serious now, boys. I've actually come round to discuss things that I've heard are going on at the BBC. They're apparently paying women a lot less than the men. It's all in the papers. Yes, it's absolutely outrageous. I'm burning inside with rage.
I think you might have got the flu too, Hat. You do look a little hot, love. Have a sit down.
Of course I haven't got your man flu, but I wouldn't mind your man wages.
Oh, well, seriously. So how much is Artie B forking out for the wonderful Hattie Jakes, then?
Well, I get a flat £40 per script, Kenneth, and £5 a line.
Well, that's settled that then, Hattie. I really could do with that honey and lemon, though.
Oh, I'm not getting you any help, Tony, until you all tell me how much you're getting.
No.
I'll tell you, I can see you need a bit of moral support, but on one condition.
What condition is that, Ken?
On condition, don't bloody hit me.
I don't like the sound of this, Kenneth. Why should I hit you? Go on.
Well, I might get a teensy bit more on account of my boyish wit and charm and all my catchphrases, like stop messing about.
Much, Kenneth. Go on. How much do you get?
Oh, I get a flat £2.50 per script and £20 a line. All my catchphrases are £25 extra.
You've let the cat out of the bag now, Kenneth. I think we'd all better duck.
That's positively outrageous, boys. That's worse than I could imagine. I bet even the scenery shifters earn more than me.
That's a laugh at scenery shifters. No, absolutely not. That really wouldn't be right, would it?
Well, how much do they get then, Tony?
Oh, well, now you come to mention it, it's about the same as you.
But they don't even have any lines to say.
No, but they have got a very strong union act, and they get £75 a show.
Oh, no, I've had enough. I'm going to leave. It's an insult to all women. I'm going straight round to the Governor-General of the BBC and going to give him a piece of my mind.
No, you mustn't do that, Hattie, for God's sake.
For heaven's sakes, why not?
I've heard he's in the mood to give men pay cuts.
I'm going to go on strike. It's just not acceptable in the modern age to discriminate against women. What have you got that I haven't got?
There's loads of difference, Hat. For starters, you couldn't play my part in Hancock's half hour, could you?
You mean I couldn't play a grumpy, washed-up, wrinkly old has-been? That's a lodger of bombastic fool, then.
Steady on, Hat. That's getting a bit hurtful, you know.
That's getting a bit hurtful.
That's very good, Hattie. If I screwed up my eyes while you were doing it, I could swear you were Hattie Jakes impersonating Sid James.
Bravo, bravo, Hattie. I might just be able to squeeze you in as Sid James in the next series. Anyway, who's this bombastic fool you were talking about? Has he been upsetting you? I'll give him a piece of my mind.
Oh dear, I think I'm getting the flu.
Man flu.
You better sit down, Hat.
honey and lemon, everyone?
No, I refuse to be ill. I will resist. Women are the stronger, but poorer, nobler sex.